5 Eyewitness News Studios, it's Twin Cities Live, your official show for summer, with your hosts, Elizabeth Reese and Chris Egert.
Well, hi, everybody. Thanks so much for joining us today. It's Wednesday, July 3rd. Today, we're going to get you all geared up for the 4th of July with some facts. We know you love the facts. With some crafts. We know you love the crafts. And a little barbecue. A little later, we're going to give you a chance to win a grill worth nearly $3,000.
Yeah, that's amazing. It's a convection oven. I can't get over it. I just learned of this yesterday.
It's amazing.
And then I've been thinking about it ever since. How does it work? I don't know. I haven't even seen it yet. If you have been bitten up by the skeeters this summer, I'm telling you, I think they're horrible.
They are bad.
They're horrific. I say that every year. They're worse than any year before. But they might really be this year because we got so much rain.
Let's just go ahead and say they're worse.
Well, we have some really cool home remedies. This is good because if you're scratching and they're driving you crazy, you can use things like mouthwash or even an onion or a banana peel. These things could go on your skin and help you out, help you solve your problems.
We're looking forward to wrapping like a banana on our forearms just as a test.
That's apparently
the deal.
We
have to put it to the test.
Yeah, although, you know, it feels like a Friday. I hope that if you're hanging out at home and you haven't left for the lake, maybe just wait it out a little bit because I've been hearing that traffic's pretty bad if you're heading out of town. 94 was a little bit of a disaster earlier today when I was running out and about. But what are your 4th of July plans? Are you hanging out in town? Are you going
anywhere? No, we're going to go see Grandma Bonnie. It's her 80th birthday,
oh,
so we're
driving over to
South Dakota to see Grandma.
How long of a drive?
Oh, about 7 hours.
Oh, man, that sounds amazing.
One way. The kids in the car, and we're bringing the dog, too. That's going to be really cool.
That sounds...
It'll be fun once we get there.
Great.
How about you?
I'm just going to be hanging out. I think that Jay and I are going to go and see the fireworks. We're going to maybe bike down to the Stone Arch Bridge, because
nice.
Mike Marcotte told us about that yesterday, so I thought that would be a good thing to do, and then just hang out, and maybe... Wedding planning, because there's always 850,000 things to do in that department.
We have room in the Suburban if you want to come with us.
Oh, I appreciate you. That is really kind. You know what? I'll let you know last minute.
Okay.
I'll let you know.
We could FaceTime on the way there.
Wow, that would be great.
Hi, Elizabeth. We're 3 hours out of town now. Okay, well, the 4th of July.
I've eaten 6 cans of Pringles.
Okay, well, obviously, 4th of July is tomorrow, but we want to bring some facts into this.
This is good. Is this like a citizenship test?
It's a little bit like a citizenship test. We go out, we talk to folks about their knowledge of the 4th of July. Here you go.
What year was the Declaration of Independence signed?
Is it 1776?
Oh, yeah, you nailed that one. Who was the first person to sign the Declaration of Independence?
I believe it was John Hancock.
No, had the biggest signature.
Who was the first person to sign the Declaration of Independence?
That would have been Hancock, right?
So, sir, you do not believe it was John Hancock who signed it first?
Yes, I do not believe he signed it first.
So what if I told you that your lovely bride was correct?
Yeah, see?
That's why I always ask.
Trust me, I understand.
How many people signed the original Declaration of Independence?
22?
I'll just guess. 13, I can't remember.
Higher.
20.
Higher.
30.
Higher.
She's going. 5.
Half of 100.
50.
Plus 6.
56.
56.
Yay. Who was the oldest person to sign the Declaration of Independence?
Franklin.
Nice.
Bonus points. How old was he?
76.
Lower.
68.
Higher.
70.
Ding, 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 ding. Winner! What was the population of the United States in 1776?
Phew, I'd be making a wild guess. 50,000.
Bunch.
I'll stick with that answer.
A bunch. Can you define that, ma'am?
Well, a bunch is a bunch, you know? At least more than 12. Get a couple of million, maybe. Not too many.
A couple million.
There was more than 56.
2.5 million.
Get out of here. Wow.
So how many people live in the United States currently?
30 million?
Higher.
150 million.
Higher.
475.
I feel like we could do this all day. The answer is 316 million. How'd you like to have some fun with some facts on grilling?
Okay.
Chances are that the pork hot dogs and sausages consumed on 4th of July originated in what state? It's one state that produces more of this.
Iowa.
That is correct. Winner, the number of hogs and pigs in the United States as of right now.
Oh, my gosh. 500,000.
Higher.
750 million.
Lower.
600 million.
65 million.
Oh, 65 million.
That's a lot of hot dogs.
That's a lot of hot dogs.
So
that is nice.
So those facts, I didn't just come up with those. So the U.S. Census Bureau
had
a whole web page dedicated to that. And the three things that they isolated were the signers of the Declaration of Independence,
okay,
the population of the United States,
yep,
then and now, which is Census Bureau,
mm-hmm,
and all those facts about meat.
Weird.
When you think of, when your government is at work right now, someone in Washington, D.C. is tabulating the amount of pigs in the United States.
That is incredible.
God bless America.
We talked about this a little bit on the radio this morning, and I was looking up study guides for the citizenship test.
Mm-hmm.
I think we should all have to take it every year just to pass to be able to stay in this country. We would have high deportation rates.
It sounds like more tax dollars being spent.
You're probably right. You know, I don't like that.
I like the idea.
Yeah, it was really interesting. It's kind of fun to go through some of those facts.
Absolutely.
And make sure that you're brushed up and you have good knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, a lot of us like to take photos of fireworks. I mean,
like to try to
since we're experiencing
fireworks.
Our whole lives through the screens of our smartphones,
yep,
these days, you,
yep,
like to take photos of fireworks and you like to Instagram them and Facebook them and then be like, ooh, ah. So we found some help for you.
This is good.
Because a lot of times those firework pics, let's be honest,
they
turn
look
out
good.
Terrible.
Mm-hmm.
They're
the
just
photos
brutal.
Are terrible.
So here are some ideas for you. This came from digitalcamerainfo.com. And here are some photos that we have from our senior producer, Christian Unser. He took them last year. Oh, man. Christian, you are a show-off. Is
wow.
that why you wanted us to show these? This is amazing.
Looks like an anemone.
That, yeah. Way to go. That was good.
Thanks.
Okay, so here's some thoughts for you. You want to hold the camera steady, so use a tripod or brace against your leg or a chair because that's going to help you make the photo less blurry.
A child's back works pretty
that's
good.
That's a good
that,
idea,
too.
Yep.
Yes.
Use a slow shutter speed. Have you ever adjusted your shutter speed? No, me neither.
It's but intimidating to even think about
it. Really
that.
Is, but here's what it does. It leaves the shutter open longer, so you'll get more of the firework trails.
Mm-hmm.
That makes sense, right? Lots
mm-hmm.
of cameras have controls for this, but if you have a pretty simple camera, just look to see if it has a night, setting,
night setting.
And you'll
okay.
want to use that.
Okay.
Okay, and then there are apps that can help you for iPhone and Android. So you can go on there and use an app, a fireworks app.
I downloaded one of those apps, and obviously there were no fireworks to take pictures of 2
no.
o'clock in the afternoon in the Twin Cities Live office.
Yeah.
But it looks like it's pretty cool. It's a little wonkish, though.
Okay.
It's kind of complicated.
Okay.
So just be warned. Don't try to do it. Don't try to download the app and then that night, 4th of July, expect
no.
that you're going to get the best picture.
Yeah.
Do a little practice.
You might have to practice. You can shoot also multiple pictures to try to get a good one, so just keep firing mm-hmm. away at them. And we have a link to this article on our website, twincitieslive.com, so you can check it out and you can get the best firework photos and maybe, you know, share them with us on our Facebook page.
That'd
We'd like
be
to
fun.
See them this weekend.
See if you can show up Christian, because his
yeah.
pictures are pretty good.
That was good, Christian.
How about a round of applause for Minnesota's own Grain Belt beer?
Bring it in, Grain Belt. Bring in the Grain Belt, Mike.
Thank you
very much.
Grain Belt.
Look at this. It's premium.
Received some high praise today.
Yes. Hello, Grain Belt.
Can I get a bottle opener? Oh,
yeah.
Wait. No. 4th of July doesn't start till tomorrow.
Twist it off, baby. Hello.
Oh. It's going to be that kind of party. All right. So, Minnesota's own Grain Belt beer.
It's the friendly beer.
had a wonderful accolade today.
I never noticed that it said that on there.
Yeah.
The friendly beer?
It's awesome.
Did you know that?
Yes.
Oh.
I mean, no, I don't consume this regularly.
Oh.
Okay, so today in Deadspin, which is an online news website,
yeah.
fun stuff. So they ranked the 36 cheap American beers.
Okay.
And this was awesome. The author is from Massachusetts.
Okay, and he did
so
a whole bunch of
So he kind of brings an
research.
East Coast bias into it. He brought his research into it, and mm-hmm. he named Grain Belt.
Premium.
Minnesota's Grain Belt number one beer.
Number one of the cheap beers.
I love this. Keystone was 36th, last on the list. Bud Light Lime was 35th. Old Milwaukee was 17th.
Yeah.
Coors Light 13th. PBR, sorry hipsters, that's 5th.
That's
Take your
pretty
skinny
good.
Jeans someplace else because the Grain Belt.
Did you see the review, though? Like what he said about
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's
okay,
awesome.
So it's so funny. So here's what he said. He said Grain Belt Premium as number one. He says, I always think of Minnesota as a secretly sexy place. And not just because of Kent Herbeck and Al Franken. Love you, Kent. Come back on the show. Maybe it's all the trout and music and Lutherans. We Lutherans are known to be very sexy.
Yeah, you need grain belts.
Toss in a smooth, creamy, and dreamy low-budget brew like Grain Belt, and it's a wonder Minnesota hasn't seceded to form its own naked blonde utopia. Grain Belt Premium is America's finest cheap beer. And to you, author of this article from Massachusetts, we say cheers. Cheers to you.
God bless America.
God bless America.
God bless.
And more in particular, God bless Minnesota.
Yeah. So I don't know. I don't really feel like doing much rest of the show. Let's just...
I'm just going to hang. I love that. I love that kind of honor because earlier this week we had to talk about the Twin Cities being ranked as like the...
Snobbiest city.
For
now,
we are keeping
it real.
You know
real.
Why we're so snobby? Because we have the best cheap beer here. So deal.
Right. We're keeping it real.
I like it.
Yeah.
You want to talk about Barbie?
Can we take this away?
Get
I can't.
It out of here.
I can't start.
I like how you wanted the bottle opener and then you forgot it was cheap beer and I just twisted that puppy right off.
I can't. It's sitting here. It's going to be distracting.
Oops.
I'm not going to get anything done.
Sorry, Bryant.
Okay. Back to work.
So there's this designer named Nicolay Lamb who created this 3D model based on the measurements of an average 19-year-old.
I love this story.
And then his idea is that this should become a Barbie because this is really what an average 19-year-old looks like. I think this is great. So he says we should make it into a Barbie.
They use the average dimensions as given by the CDC, and they came up with this composite, a different Barbie you see on the right, the typical Barbie on the left.
Well, there's no question.
This
regular
is supposed to be a more regular American woman.
There's no way that regular Barbie's body could hold up that head. I mean, it's impossible. Her head is ginormous for the size of her body.
She does have a giant melon.
Yeah. It's true, and that's just not even realistic.
That's why
she can have so many careers, because she has such a big brain and such a big head.
Exactly.
Doctor Barbie, firefighter Barbie.
Right. Always wanted to think big.
Veterinarian Barbie.
So the whole thing is taking the internet by storm today. This different version of Barbie. The idea is that perhaps Mattel would think of something like that, sort of introduce a different ideal body form to young ladies.
Don't you think? They've been talking about how Barbie's body is unrealistic for years and years. Has anything changed?
Nope.
No.
Nada.
Nada. But Grain Belt Premium is still the number one cheap beer in the country.
Can we bring that back out here?
Can you bring in that?
It's already put
away. Where did it go?
Okay.
Hey, you want to pick up a pair of our Twin Cities Live sunglasses? I have to say, it's the accessory of the summer here. At any of our summer events, you're going to need them to win a trip for two to anywhere in the continental United States from Delta Vacations. And then we're also featuring a photo on the show each day. If we pick yours, you win that coveted TCL t-shirt. Look at this, Chris.
Oh, well, this is Lenore Carlson from Minneapolis. And her little garden fox. Look, it not only has the Twin Cities Live sunglasses on it, but it's got a Twin Cities Live headband.
That is terrific.
How fun is that?
Lenore is a woman after my own heart because she's retired and she loves gardening in her backyard. That's going to be me
someday. Isn't that awesome? We'll find out where you can pick up a pair of our sunglasses. Head to the official summer calendar on TwinCitiesLive.com.
Yes!
And I'm just saying this might be an idea that I just came up with this. Imagine what you could come up with.
Good. That was very impressive. Grain Belt Premium.
Oh, I was supposed to put it on my eyes.
Oh, you can wear it. That looks really cool.
All right.
Hey, coming up next, our good friend Alexis from MyTalk 107.1 is here. Oh my gosh, she's so creative. And she has 4th of July craft ideas that'll be just as much fun for the adults as they are for kids. Could she be any cuter? Alexis. Woo!